Hey guys, what's going on? It's Dokonic here, and today we're going to be doing an event overview of the horrific cell games on top of the cards that are available to help weaken his regeneration. So with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and jump right into the event. First, I just want to state that I will not be going over the Link skills or any of the free-to-play characters in this video with the Link skill Soul versus Soul. Now, if you're not aware, Soul versus Soul is the Link skill that also allows to the regeneration to be weakened. I will be doing a separate video on the free-to-play characters that have this trait in order to help you take on this event. Specifically, in this video, I will be going over the primary characters that actually have it as their passive, so that way they don't need that link in order to weaken Cell's regeneration. If you don't know what regeneration is, stay tuned. I'm going to be going over that in the next couple of minutes. But with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about each of the levels. Now, level one of the event, the Cell game. This isn't a major thing. You just go up against Cell in each different level. On normal, you go up against an agility first form Cell. On hard, you go up against the strength second form Cell. And on Z hard, you go up against the evolved form Cell perfect form. He is an agility unit, and he drops the agility first form Cell. It's called Cell Fusion Cell. Yeah, really good name. First form. It's a 25% drop rate. He Dokken awakens into the actual agility unit, the evolved form Cell, perfect form. He is very useful on an LR Frieza team. So if you don't have him, grind him out. He comes out around the time of the LR Frieza, so make sure you get him up to Super Attack 10. He will be viable. Dokken awaken him. Level 2, the Extreme Terror. This is just a one-shot event. It's a Z-Hard event. You go up against the Technique Cell. It's one of the old school, the old meta, the original Dokken exclusive meta with the Ki plus 3, Attack plus 3000, so the flat-out boost leader. You go up against an Extreme Technique type. He drops one metal. And it's really not that hard. He does have a regeneration of about 325 to 375,000, I believe, when it hits off. So yes, this character's a little gimmick or whatever you want to call it. He regenerates health for about 325 to 370,000 when it goes off. You'll see a little icon with like a band-aid or a medic sign, a little plus with the red on it. That way you know he is going to use that. So you want to make sure that you have a character. Think of it like an attack. When you get attacked by an enemy, you want to have the specific character with that link skill weakens regeneration, the link skill Soul versus Soul, or the passive skill weakens regeneration in that field. But that's that event. You can easily overpower that event because that's an old school event. Level 3, Nightmare in Broad Daylight. Now this one's a little bit tougher. The first round of level 3, you go up against 5 Cell Juniors. 2 physical, 1 agility, 1 intelligence, and 1 technique. They aren't that powerful, but if you don't have a strong team, it's going to be a pain in the butt to get through that. I just recommend trying, if you have an AoE, that might be a little bit more helpful. LR Broly, definitely, he will knock them all out. Maybe not the agility one right off the bat. He'll knock them all out. If you have an extreme team, that's good. Second round, you go up against the technique form that you went up last time, except this time it is his undoken form. It's still, he has that that special ability that he regenerates health. So make sure you have Link Soul versus Soul or Weakened Regeneration passive. Stay tuned. I'm still going to be going over those cards in a little bit. The third round is going to be you go up against the Strength Cell. Here you go up against Cell. His regeneration ability has gone up. He can regenerate up to 450,000 health points on this round. So you have the second round where he's regenerating about 325 to 375,000, and this round up to 450,000. Now, yes, I do understand. Any of you who have a really OP team do not have to worry about this. But for those of you who do not have really OP teams, you need to make sure you have that link skill or that passive skill that's going off. Otherwise, you will not be able to take on this event. It will take you a very long time, and chances are he's just going to regenerate to full health. But with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the characters with the passive skill weakens regeneration. The first one is going to be the undoken form, Flawless Combat Android 18. Now, this is assuming you haven't dokened her, because that's why you're watching this video. Her leader skill is irrelevant because you do not want her as a leader. Technique, intelligence, strength type, HP, and attack plus 20%. Her super attack, sadistic dance, causes extreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill, Despair's Grin, weakens regeneration and changes rainbow key to intelligence. Her link skills are Infinite Energy, Android Assault, Twin Terrors, The Innocence, Battlefield Diva, Soul vs. Soul, and Nightmare. Her max stats are HP of 8748, attack of 6699, and defense of 4624. So she's really good. She has the Soul vs. Soul trait that you want to use in order to go after Cell. She is one of them, but her passive skill is really the one that weakens regeneration and makes sure he doesn't regenerate his own health. The next one is True Might Android 17. Again, this is the Undoken form, and again, he has a horrible leader skill. Technique, intelligence, and strength type key plus 2. They kind of like made it so that way they work off each other. You have one Android 18 as a leader, then an Android 17 as a leader. So that way you get the key, and you get the little attack and HP buff. Not really that good, but again, those were the old meta of the game. Super attack, sadistic dance, causes extreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill, Whispered Madness, weakens regeneration, changes agility key to rainbow key. Link skills, Infinite Energy, Android Assault, Twin Terrors, The Innocence, Infighter, Soul vs. Soul, and Fear and Faith. His max stats are HP of 8588, attack of 7019, and defense of 4301. Again, I'm not going to be going over his Doken Awakened form because this is assuming you are trying to beat the event without the Doken Awakened versions. You need those medals. The next one is a crappy card in itself. He's a horrible unit in my opinion. Pure Confidence, Super Vegeta. He has a super attack called Final Flash, causes extreme damage to the enemy. His leader skill is Agility, Strength, and Physical type, HP and attack plus 30%. His passive skill, Promise of Power, weakens regeneration, agility, and physical type key plus 2. So I guess he's supposed to be a support unit. Link skills are Golden Warrior, Saiyan Warrior Race, Super Saiyan Prodigies, Z Fighters, and Soul vs. Soul. His max stats are HP of 7350, attack of 7064, and defense of 5245. Now he technically has a Doken Awakening on JP. I don't know exactly what that is at this point, but it's not relevant because we're on global. This is probably the only time that this card is actually going to be relevant because he is an agility card with the weakens regeneration link. He doesn't hit hard, he doesn't have a good anything. I mean, yeah, I guess the agility and physical type key plus 2 makes him a valid support unit, but he is just horrible all around the board. He has bad attack, I guess defense is decent, but that doesn't come into play until you have 120 lead. But yeah, if you need someone with a weakened regeneration link, he'll be good for the strength version, just keep him away from the tech version. The next one we're going to be going over is the Undokened and the Doken version, because his Doken Awakening version comes from the Intelligence Trunks event. This is the Swelling Power Super Trunks. I'm not going to go over his full card details, but he has weakened regeneration and his attack is plus 40%, and he has a Soul vs. Soul link. He Doken Awakens into the Convergent Fury Super Trunks. His leader skill is All Types Attack plus 40%. His super attack is Buster Cannon, causes supreme damage to the enemy and raises attack for 3 turns. His passive skill is Duel of Might, key plus 4 and attack plus 60% at the start of turn, and weakens regeneration. His link skills are Golden Warrior, Messenger from the Future, Super Saiyan, the Vegeta Family, Prepared for Battle, and Soul vs. Soul, and Fierce Battle. So he'll be someone who actually you could throw on a team of a lot of Doken Awakened characters because he has that Fierce Battle link. His max stats are HP of 9021, attack of 8169, and defense of 4439. Now, all these cards that I just mentioned to you, all of them are really relevant for this event if you don't have a hard-hitting team. Now, I mean, this event, you can even go after him. I mean, it's a strength card, right? Now, I'm pretty sure I've seen multiple YouTubers go after him with a full physical team, a 120 lead physical team with the Korra, and they just destroyed him. It is very easy to overpower the Cell. It comes down to how much damage output you put per round versus how much he could regenerate. He's only regenerating about 500,000. In the current meta of the game, especially now that you have like that LR Broly, we got the dupe system really early, like I'm running 100% Gogeta. I'm gonna hit him for 1,000,000 per card. He's only gonna regenerate half of one of my card's maximum hits. He's not gonna last. Again, this is specifically for those of you who don't have those hard hitting units. Just make sure you take that into consideration. But with that being said, guys, I will be doing a different video that goes over the Soul versus Soul link, at least the cards that have the link skill Soul versus Soul. I mean, I do those specific videos for those of you who have good, decent cards that can go up against villains like this or go up against events like this. But you might be lacking one or two cards that are actually relevant. So stay tuned for that. I will be dropping that. If I haven't dropped it already, I'll be dropping it either today or tomorrow. I'm pre-recording all this information because that's going to be a busy week for me. But hey, thank you for taking the time to stop by and watch this video. I hope this was helpful for you. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you're new here, and I'll catch you all in the next video.